Hey everyone, this is Josh from HostGator. Today I'm going to show you how to install WordPress and get logged in so you can start building your new site. Let's get started. So here we are at portal.hostgator.com. We have an earlier video that shows you how to log in here and the cPanel, but we'll log in today with our email address and our password that's used for the account. So let's scroll down and check out the hosting packages that I have on this plan. I've got two. One is a shared business and one is a cloud hatchling, and we can easily launch into the cPanel by clicking here on the right-hand icon. Today, to install WordPress, we're going to be using the Softaculous Web Apps Installer. We can type soft to our quick search function or scroll down to the software section and click the Softaculous Apps Installer. Now this takes us to a new portal where we can install any content management system that we want. We've got the big name players like WordPress, Joomla, PrestaShop, and a whole bunch of other content management systems that you can install really quickly on any domain that you have. Before we get started with the actual install, let's take a look at what's already installed on my account in the installation section up here in the top. We can click that and I can see I already have one WordPress installed on my primary domain for b-radpit.com. If I wanted to go to the site and take a look at what it looks like, I could click here. If I wanted to go to the WordPress admin and log in automatically, I could click here. We can see when it was installed, the current version of WordPress that it's using, and we've got some other options over here if we want to edit or delete that installation. Now that I see which ones are already installed, let's go back to the front page of Softaculous by clicking on the top left. And we'll hover over WordPress, which is the one that I wanted to install today. Now, WordPress is awesome if you want to get started with a website really quickly. You can get a new blog spun up, start building out an e-commerce site. It's by far one of the most popular CMSs on the web. Probably 30 to 40% of the websites that you frequent use WordPress. And it's really, really awesome platform to start building. If you want to take a look at some more information for WordPress, you can go to the overview tab. If you want to demo what WordPress looks like before you get started, you can click the demo section. And if you want to get started with the install, we can click the install section here. So this is going to bring us to a new tab where it's going to ask us some information about the WordPress install that we're going to do. The first thing it's going to ask us is the version that we want to install. Like any good software, WordPress is constantly being updated by its developers to fix security holes, patches, and keep the content updated. So it's going to default to the newest version every time, and I always like to ensure that we're installing the newest version so that everything is nice and secure. So we'll make sure that 5.4 is selected, and it should be by default. And the next thing that we're going to do is choose the installation URL. So this is going to be the domain that we want to install WordPress on. And there's a cool drop-down section here where it'll show all the domains on my account that I can install to. This first one is my primary domain, and it's already got a WordPress install, so we don't want to install there. Let's take a look at the HD testing account and click that, and that's going to be the one that we install to today. You can also choose the protocol here that you want to install to, and this is the difference between having an SSL on your site and not having an SSL on your site. The SSL goes through HTTPS and the non-SSL goes through HTTP. The cool thing about HostGator and especially shared and cloud accounts is that we offer free installations of SSLs on every domain that you have on your plan. So if the domain is already pointed to your account and it's added as an add-on domain, it usually takes about 5 to 10 minutes for that installation of the SSL to take place. And that means you can start using a secure connection to your site every time someone visits your website. Now, since HT testing account has already been on my account for a while and I know that there's an SSL installed, I'll go ahead and leave HTTPS as an option. But if you want to build with pure HTTP or add the www to it, you can select that option here. I do want to mention that there's the indirectory section here. Now we'll leave that blank today because I want to install directly on hgtestingaccount.com. But say you have a domain that already has WordPress built up on it, and you want to install on a different folder. So say hgtestingaccount.com/new website. You can install in a new directory and just essentially name the directory here and it'll create and install it for you. Now this is cool if you want to spin up a new development site, start building something new while your old site is still accessible. But today I want to install on the domain itself, and I don't want to install into a subdirectory, so we'll just leave that blank. Now here in the second section is the site settings, and this is where we can give our blog title a name and a description. Now this can be changed really easily after the fact when you log into your WordPress admin, but if you wanted to give the site title a name for either your business or blog, you can do that here. You can easily just put in whatever the name of your blog needs to be and a description of it. For me, my blog and my WordPress blog is fine because I just wanted to demo this install today. Now there's an option here for enable multi-site, and it's going to be unchecked by default. And then multi-site is essentially a way to manage multiple WordPresses through a single database. It's a little bit tricky and complicated to get started. So if you're just installing WordPress for the first time, we'll go ahead and leave this unchecked. The next section here is admin account. Now, this is going to be really important because this is how you'll actually log into your WordPress through the WP admin. So we're going to choose a username and a password so that we can easily log in. Now, by default, WordPress always chooses admin as the username. Now, that can pose a little bit of a security risk because if someone who is trying to guess your password or hack into your site, they could automatically assume that the username was admin since that's the default. So I always like to encourage people to change it, something that means something to you and that's not admin. So for me, I'm going to change this to Josh HostGator, and we're going to set a really secure password down here. Now, you can type in any password that you want, and as long as it's secure, we always want to make sure that we're using secure passwords. Or you can have it generate a new password for you by clicking this key. It'll usually generate a pretty secure password, and it'll give you the strength indicator at the bottom. You can always add on to that if you'd like. So now that we have a username and a password, what I like to do is copy this over to a text document or some sort of key pass so that we know we have this safe for later. And we can log into WordPress automatically through cPanel, but we always want to give ourselves an option to log in through the WordPress admin directly. So we'll copy those for safekeeping. The next thing that we'll choose here is the admin email. And it's important to use an email address here that you know you can get email to, because if you ever lose your password for WordPress, you can easily reset it by sending an email to this account. So whichever email you prefer to use, you can use that here. The next thing that we're going to do is select our default language. We've got a host of options here. I'll default to English. The next option is going to allow us to install new plugins on the site if we want to automatically as WordPress installs. Now, you'll have the opportunity to install any plugin that you want and change the theme once you get logged into the WordPress admin, but it gives you a few options here for the classic editor, limiting the login attempts for someone who's trying to guess your password, or managing multiple WordPresses. Since I don't need to do any of that, I'll leave those blank today. You won't necessarily have to change anything here in the advanced options setting, but I'll show you a few of the things inside of here just to give you some more information. When Softaculous installs WordPress, it actually creates a brand new database for you and your site, and it does it automatically during the installation process. If you wanted to change the name of the WordPress database, you could do so here, but you can leave it blank or whatever the default is, and it'll install it on that database. You can change the table prefix if you want a custom prefix. Again, that's something that's a little bit more advanced, but it's always an option to change later if you need to as well. You can disable update notifications emails here. You can also choose if you want WordPress to upgrade automatically. So if there's a new version of WordPress that rolls out and you want WordPress to go ahead and update automatically each time, you can click the options here. I like to leave it to do not auto upgrade because I like to manage this through the back end of WordPress. You can also give it the options to upgrade WordPress plugins and themes automatically, but I'll leave those blank today too because we can do that in the WordPress admin as well. Last but not least, this gives us an option to select a new theme. Now, once you install WordPress, it's automatically going to install the default theme for the year. This year's theme is 2020, and I think it looks pretty cool, but if something down here catches your eye, you can click select, and it'll actually install and activate that theme for you right away. Once you have everything correct and you've noted your username and password, we'll go ahead and click install and we'll let Softaculous do all the work for us. Now it's important to not close the browser tab while this is happening as it could interrupt the install. It usually takes 1 to 2 minutes and sometimes it can take a few minutes longer depending on the speed of your internet and the speed of the server. And cool, we just installed WordPress. You'll see this congratulations message here, and it'll show you that WordPress has been installed to your specific domain, and it'll actually give you an option to log into the WP admin right away. So if you want to take a look at what the site looks like, click that top link. And then pretty cool, here's my new WordPress blog. You can scroll down and see that we already have a first post. It's got my username listed there and the date. And it looks pretty sweet. So this is when you could start building up your WordPress, and I'll show you how to get logged into the WordPress admin. We'll click back to Softaculous, and we can click the second link down here, which is the administrative URL. Notice that it's yourdomain.com/wp-admin. We'll click here, and it'll log us into the WordPress admin automatically. And here's the back end of WordPress. So here's where you can start customizing your site, change your theme, add a new plugin. You can write a blog post, add pictures, really start building up your site as much as you want to. And we'll have different posts coming forward in the future about how we can maneuver around in the back end of WordPress and do some fun stuff. But for now, I wanted to show you how to actually get it installed and log in. So thanks so much for watching. I really appreciate y'all taking the time to look at these videos. I hope you have fun building your new website. And if you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. If you've got new requests for videos, you can also leave those in the comments. Take a look at everything that we've got and feel free to subscribe for more helpful video content. Thanks, y'all. Have a great day.